نحمد ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. The book of fasting, Kitab al-Siyam, and we'll continue. This is part 9. Act which vitiate or disrupt fast. أشياء التي تفسد الصوم. Sexual intercourse while fasting vitiates the fast. There is atonement for it and also to make up for the violated fast. You shouldn't do it. If you did it, you have to do you, again. You have to make up that fast and this is a sin. You should avoid that. The atonement for the vitiated fast is freeing of one's sleep. You have to what you have to do? Now you did the mistake. You have to first thing. Freeing one's slave. If it is not possible, then fasting continuously for 2 months. If it is not possible, feeding 60 needy person. The third option is 60 needy person. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu transmits, we were sitting with Allah's messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is a longer hadith. Inshallah, I'll explain you. Then a companion arrived and said, O Allah's messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I am ruined. He is saying, I am ruined. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam inquired, what is the matter? He said, I had sexual intercourse with my wife in the state of fasting. He did by the mistake. And he is saying, I am ruined because I did in the state of fasting. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked, can you free a slave? He said, no, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then he asked, can you fast continuously for 2 months? The person said, no, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Again, sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked, can you feed 60 needy persons? He said, no, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then sit down and remain silent for some time. Like he was sitting there and he was silent. While we were sitting in that condition, an arkh of dates, you know, that somebody brought lot of dates for Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Arkh is a big container that contains lot of dates. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam inquired, where is the questioner of the percept? You know, he asked, where is he, where he went? He said, I am here, I am present here. Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, take these dates and distribute them by the way of charity. He said, okay, go and distribute on your behalf, because you can't do all those three, now you distribute it. The person then asked, O Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, should I give these dates in charity to the people who are more needy than myself? He's asking, you know, because he's a poor person. He's saying, I am so needy. Should I give more than like myself? By Allah, there is no house in the entire Medina poorer than me. He's saying that to sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I am more poorer than whole in the Medina. So Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam laughed so much so that his teeth were visible. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated, give these dates to the members of your household. Subhanallah. So he was given that charity to his own members because he is the most poor person. So transmitted by Bukhari and Muslim. But what we learn from this, if you did this, what you have to do first and foremost, you have to free a slave. If you can't do that, continuously fast for 2 months. If you can't do that, then you have to feed 60 needy persons. Okay, 60 needy person. So depending on your situation, you have to give how much each meal will be. You can give the money or you make the food and distribute accordingly. Sayyid bin Musayyib radiallahu anhu relates that a person visited Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, I have disrupted the fast of Ramadan. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated, give charity and ask Allah for forgiveness and make up for the disrupt fast. You know, first he said, give charity and make up the fast. Explanation, even today if such condition occurs, the person should expiate for the disrupted fast by performing one of the three modes of the attainment according. If it is incapable of any attainment, he should give charity accordingly to his means. But when he is able to fulfill one of the three modes of expiation, he should attain by adopting one of them. As I mentioned before, what we discuss, all the three things, like, you know, the last one will be feeding the 60 people, needy people. Fast is disturbed by the intentional vomiting, and it is obligatory to make up the disturbed fast. You know, it didn't happen, like, you know, you didn't accidentally you vomit, it won't break your fast. But literally you putting your fingers in your mouth and taking out, doing the vomiting intentionally, it will break the fast, okay? Fast is not disrupted by an involuntary vomiting. As I mentioned, you know, you're pregnant, you're nursing. Sometimes, you know, because of some nausea, even though like you are not married yet, but still you feel like, you know, you had something because of that. Or sometimes, you know, because you didn't sleep well, you feel like vomiting, nausea. It's like natural thing. It doesn't break your fast. But intentionally, like, you know, forcefully you are doing it, that will break your fast. So let it happen natural. If it naturally comes out, it's nothing wrong. It won't break your fast. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu narrates that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated, when a person who is fasting vomits involuntarily, the fast is not disrupted. However, if vomiting is intentionally, he should make up for the disrupted fast. This is in Abu Dawud and Ibn Majah. The fast of a woman is disrupted by commencement of menstrual or puberal condition. The disrupted fast should be made up, but not the prayer. As we mentioned before, like, in what if, you know, she had her period and it was the even before 5 minutes of the Maghrib, still she had to make up that fast. You know, people have that misconception, oh, after 11, if she sees the period, she can continue no matter if she is not praying. No, it's not so. That is the misconception. They are like, you know, we created ourselves. But what is the sunnah of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Even 5 minutes before, if you see the period, that's break the fast, and then you have to make up that fast later on. Okay. Abu Sa'id Khudri radiallahu anhu narrates that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated, it is not the fact that when a woman is in menstrual state, she can neither pray nor fast. That is a lapse for her in the religion. Transmitted by Bukhari. Next chapter, Siyamut Tatawu, Superiority Fast. Excellence of Superiority Fast, that is Nawafil. Abu Sa'id Khudri radiallahu anhu narrates that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated, whoever observes a superiority fast for one day during war, Allah will keep him away from the hell at a distance of 70 years of traveling. This is in Bukhari and Muslim. Fasting for 6 days in Shawwal every year is equivalent to fast for the entire life. You know, you fast 29-30 days of Ramadan, and after that you continue with the 6 days of Shawwal. It's as if you fast for entire life. Abu Ayyub Ansari radiallahu anhu narrates that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated, whoever after completing the fast of Ramadan fast for 6 days in Shawwal every year, he will be rewarded as if he has been fast for the entire life. This is in Muslim, Abu Dawud, Tirmidhi and Ibn Majah. Here 30 plus 6, you know, 36 into 10 is 360, reward for 360 days of fasting. In other words, for the whole year, if like, you know, after Ramadan in every year, the 6 days of fasting in Shawwal are observed regularly every year, the reward will be equivalent to fasting for the entire life. Fasting regularly during the days of Bid. Ayyam-e-Bid is 13, 14 and 15th of lunar calendar with the moon sighting. Will earn the reward equivalent to fast for the entire life. You know, make a habit of fasting on Ayyam-e-Bid. Abu Qatada radiallahu anhu narrates that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated, fasting for Ramadan from one to another and fasting for 3 days of Bid, bright nights in every lunar month, is equivalent to fasting for entire life. It is permissible to observe superiority fast while traveling. Hamza bin Amr Aslami radiallahu anhu has transmitted that he inquired the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, shall I fast while traveling? Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam replies, "You may fast if you like or leave if you like." This is in Nisa'i. Fasting during the journey of jihad or hajj will keep away from hell at distance of 70 years traveling. The superiority fast on Monday and Thursday was liked by Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. These are nawafil. Okay, Abu Huraira radhiyallahu anhu narrates that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated, "Deeds of people are present before Allah on Monday and Thursday. I would like to be in state of fasting when my deeds are presented before Allah." This is transmitted in Tirmizi. Fasting on the day of Arafat, 9th Zulhijjah, is expiation for minor sins committed during 2 years, past 1 year and the next year. Fasting on the day of Ashura, 10th Muharram, is expiation for minor sins and committed during the last 1 year. Qatada radiyallahu anhu narrates that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated, "Fasting on the day of Arafat is expiation for the sins committed during 2 years, past 1 year and the next year, and the fasting on the day of Ashura is expiation for sins committed in past 1 year. It is unbecoming to fast only on the 10th of Muharram." Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam observed more fast in the month of Shaban than in any other months. Aisha radhiyallahu anha states that, "I have not seen Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam fast for the whole month except in Ramadan, nor did I see Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam fasting excessively in any other month but Shaban." This is in Bukhari and Muslim. Explanation is, all tradition regarding fasting and being awake in the night of the 15th Shaban are spurious. At the most, what is established by genuine is tradition is that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam observed fast excessively in the month of Shaban. The most excellent mode of superiority fast is to observe fast every alternate day. Abdullah bin Amr radiyallahu anhu narrates that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated, "Fast for 3 days in a month." I said, "I have more strength than that." Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam prevailed upon me to decrease the number of fasts so much so that he stated, "Fast for a day and do not fast the next day. Fast on the alternate day. These are the most excellent fast. This was practiced by my brother Dawood al-Islam." This is transmitted in Bukhari and Muslim. Excellence of fasting in Muharram. Abu Huraira radiyallahu anhu narrates that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated, "After Ramadan, the most excellent days for fasting are during Muharram, which is the month of Allah. After obligatory prayer, the most excellent prayer is Tahajjud prayer." Excellence of fasting on Monday. Abu Qatada radiyallahu anha relates that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam was asked about observing fast on Monday. He stated, "I was born on Monday, and it was on Monday that the revelation of the Quran commenced." This is transmitted in Muslim. It is masnoon to have fast on the first 9 days of Zilhajj on any 3 days of every month, just like I mentioned before, Ayyam may be 13, 14 and 15. It is desirable to fast any 3 days of every month. It is the tradition of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to have a fast on Monday and any 2 Thursday of every month. Some of the Prophet's wives narrate that he sallallahu alaihi wasallam would fast on first 9 days of Zilhajj, on 10th of Muharram and on 3 days of every month. First Monday and two Thursdays, transmitted by Nisa'i. The intention for superiority fast can be formed any time before noon, provided one has not eaten or drank anything. You know, for Nawafil fast, you can make your intention, and previously we already discussed about it, how Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, like in the afternoon, he asked, "Nothing is left." So he said, "Okay, I'm going to fast." even though he didn't make the intention before dawn, before Fajr. But for the Nawafil, you can make intention that time. Making up of disrupted or omitted superlative fast is not compulsory. You know, like you break your fast, that is Nawafil fast, you break it. So you don't have to make up that fast, right? We discussed this before also. For supererogative fast, you don't have to make up. It is excellent to adopt moderation in supererogative fast. You know, make it very moderate means, you know, how much you can fast. Siyam Arabin, 40 days of fasting is not established by any tradition of Allah's Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. There is no such thing like, you know, fasting 40 days. I don't know, some people made it or what it is. There is no such thing like fasting for 40 days. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka.